Okay, so guys, I'm starting the class again. So simplex method. This is our session number two. So good morning, everyone. This is Amit Kumar Singh, and in this session, we are solving another problem on simplex method. So this was your question that maximization of z is equal to 1 plus 8x2, where three constraints are given to us. That x1 plus x2 should be less than or equal to 10, 2x1 plus 2x2 should be less than or equal to 25, and x1 plus 5x2 should be less than or equal to 35, where x1 and x2 should be greater than or equal to 0. So in simplex method, whenever you see the objective function should always be maxima. In case your objective function was given as minima, in case in your problem, if the objective function, if that problem was given like this, something like this, that minimization of z is equal to 6x1 plus 8x2. So what you would have done, you would have converted the minima into maxima by changing their sign. So you cannot proceed a simplex method with an objective called minima. So for the simplex method, the very important thing you have to see that the objective function should always be maxima. Next thing, while solving the problem, when you see the constraints, the constraint should be less than or equal to here. So the constraint should always be, the constraint what you see, it should be less than or equal to only. Then only you can introduce slack variable. In case if your constraint is greater than or equal to, then we'll introduce a negative slack variable. So such kind of problem where your constraints are greater than or equal to, such kind of problem we'll solve by another method that is called Big M method. Big M method. So Big M method is a derivative of simplex method. So such kind of problem, if your constraint was given to you greater than or equal to, then we'll go with the another formulation of simplex method that is called Big M method. Okay, so the few things you need to be very vigilant. The questions which are easy on simplex method, so such questions, the first thing you need to see that the objective function should be maxima. In case if the objective function is not maxima, then you'll convert that minima into maxima by changing the sign of that variable. And the next thing, when you see, next thing you have to see the constraints. So here you have three constraints. Here in this problem, you have three constraints. So these three constraints, you will convert this inequation into equation by introducing slack variables. So because here there are three constraints, so you will introduce three slack variables. So let those three slack variables are S1, S2, and S3. Why you're introducing that slack variable? So that you can make this equation equal to the RHS. So here your x1 plus x2 is less than or equal to 10. So what I'll do, I'll introduce a variable called S1. Here I'll introduce a variable called S1 so that if x1 plus x2 is less than 10, then x1 will take that difference. Or if x1 plus x2 is equal to 10, then the S1 would be equal to 0. So that is the agenda here. That is the idea. That is the mathematical logic of why we are introducing these slack variable, because we want to convert the inequation into equation. Now for solving the problem, what we'll do, we'll write few lines in exam. When you get this problem in exam, you write few lines on them, right? Saying that since there are three constraints are there in the problem, so in order to solve this problem, what you will do, you will introduce three slack variable so that you can convert this inequation into equation. Okay, so then once you introduce those three slack variables, then after that you write the same equation like maxima of z is equal to 6x1 plus 8x2 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 plus 0s3 subject to x1 plus x2 plus s1 equal to 10, then 2x1 plus 3x2 plus s2 is equal to 25, and then x1 plus 5x2 plus s3 is equal to 35, And then you write non-negative restriction, X1, X2, S1, S2, S3, they should be greater than or equal to zero. Okay, so you have to write this much. So once you're done with this equation formulation, this is very important. So this steps is very important. So you have to write in this form. Anyone have doubt till now? Please write in the chat box if anyone have doubt. Anyone have any doubt? Okay, so I'm assuming that you have understood everything. So now based on this, what you'll do, you'll draw a table. Based on this, you'll draw a table. Okay, so you'll start a table. So you can see here, you have X1, you have X2, you have S1, you have S2, you have S3. The coefficient of them, you can see that is 6, 8, 0, 0, 0. So this is 6, this is 8, this is 0, this is 0, this is 0. Okay, and these are called CI. I'll call them as a CI. Okay, now right hand side, you have RHS. Okay, right hand side you have RHS, you have theta. Okay, now here I'll write, we'll always start the problem with the slack variable. So these slack variables, they have a I'll start the problem with slack variable. So these slack variable, they have the coefficient called zero. Now I'll write the equation. Kishore, if you have any doubt, ask me. So you can see in your screen, this is the first equation. This is your first equation. So I'll write them here. So the coefficient of X1 is 1. Coefficient of X2 is 1. S1 is 1. In the first equation, there's no S2 and S3. So put 0 and 0. We consider zero as because we believe they are dummy variable. The idea of introducing them, this slack variable is to convert the inequation into equation. They are dummy variables. They will become active only when, if for the first equation, if the sum of x1 and x2 is less than zero. If the sum of x1 and x2 is equal to zero, then they don't hold any existence. The idea of introducing them so that we can convert the inequation into equation. They are not in the problem. We have introduced them in the problem for our convenience so that we can convert that inequation part into equation part. Now for the second equation, if you see the second equation, so the second equation is this. This is your second equation. You can see the coefficient. This is 2x1 plus 3x2. There's no s1 there, so put 0. S2 is 1, s3 is 0. Okay, now see the third equation. This is your third equation. So the third equation, if you see, this is x1 is 1, x2 is 5, and this s1 is 0, s2 is 0, s3 is 1. Now you can write the RHS. The RHS, if you see, the RHS of this is 10. So you can write here 10. The RHS of this is 25. You can write here 25. The RHS of this is 35. You can write here 35. Good, Shruti. Okay. First, you have to write them like this way. So once this is done, once this is done, so then you'll find their ZI. Once this is done, you'll find their ZI. The first time when you do the ZI first time would always be zero, because what is ZI? What is basically your ZI? ZI is basically this 0 into 1 plus 0 into 2 plus 0 into 1. So that is your ZI, 0 into 1 plus 0 into 3 plus 0 into 5. Then 0 into 1 plus 0 into 0 plus 0 into 0. So the first time whatever you do, your ZI is always 0 only, because the first step when we are introducing, in the first step you can see you are starting with slack variable. So because you are starting with slack variable, so and the slack variable having the coefficient 0, so the ZI, the first step, the ZI is always 0 only. So CI minus ZI is 6 8 0 0 0. Out of all CI minus ZI, you have to see that CI minus ZI which is maximum. So which is maximum? So the maximum CI minus ZI is 8. It means X2 will enter into the solution. That means X2 will enter into the solution, and X2 will either replace S1 or S2 or S3. How to determine that? To determine that, what you'll do, you have to see this element. You have to see these elements. These elements are called as pivot element. These elements are called as pivot element. You have to see these elements. You have to see these elements. These elements are called pivot element. And then what you will do, you will divide all the RHS by this pivot element. You will divide all your RHS by this pivot element. Okay. So you have to divide all your RHS by this pivot element. So this is 10 divided by 1, that is 10. This is 25 divided by 3, that is 8.33. This is 35 divided by 5, that is equal to 7. So out of all this value, what you get, we call them theta. So out of all theta, you have to see the value which is minimum. So the minimum theta is 7. It means S3 will exit the solution. It means S3 will exit the solution. Okay, now the point of intersection, you can see here that X2 is entering into the initial basic solution. X2 is entering into the solution and it is replacing X2 is entering to the solution and it is replacing X3 and it is replacing S3. So that you have to understand. And the point of intersection of X2 and S3, if you see the X2 and S3, the point of intersection of S2 and X3, the point of intersection of X2 and X3, which is 5, the point of intersection of X2 and X3, that is 5. This 5 is called pivot element. This 5 is called pivot element. Okay, so the 5 and all these element will play very significant role in the next step of calculation. So you have to understand that which is entering. So how to decide which variable is entering out of X1, X2, S1, S2, S3. To decide which variable is entering, to decide that we have to see CI minus ZI. So the variable having the maximum CI minus ZI, that variable is entering to the solution, and that variable will replace one of the slack variable, one of the variable which is present here. That variable will replace one of the variable which is present here. To determine which variable it is replacing, for that we determine the theta. We determine the theta. So out of all theta, whichever is the minimum theta, so the corresponding to that variable will exit the solution. Good, Devraj. Okay, now once you understood this, so now the 5 is your pivot element. Now I'll go ahead with this. Okay, so now I'll write S1 Now I'll write S1 0, S2 0, and in place of S3, X2 will come. And X2 have which what coefficient? 8. Okay. Now, how to find the value of X2? So how to find the value of X2? So how will you find the value of X2? The value of X2 you will find by dividing all the elements. Here X2 is your pivot element. So what you do, you have to divide all the element of this. Now you have to write the value of X2. Now you have to write the value of X2. X2 is replacing S3. So how will you find the value of X2? You will find the value of X2 by dividing all the element of S3 by the pivot element. Your pivot element is 5. So the value of X2 would be 1 by 5. The first value, 1 divided by 5. Then 5 divided by 5 is 1. Then 0 divided by 5 is 0. 0 divided by 5 is 1. 0 divided by 5 is 0, and 1 divided by 5 is 1 by 5, and 35 divided by 5 is 7. So that will give you the value of X2. Okay, so this will give you the value of X2. Ask me, anyone have any doubt on this? So what Shruti you have to understand here in this problem, you have to understand that here you can see here that S3 is replaced by X2. You can see here S3 is replaced by X2. Now in place of S3, X2 came. Now, how will you write the value of X2? To write down the value of X2, you have to first see what is a pivot element. What is your pivot element? Pivot element is 5. So, how you got to know that 5 is a pivot element? Because 5 is the point of intersection of S3 and X2. 5 is the point. 5 is the point of intersection. 5 is the point of intersection of S3 and X2. Once you understood that 5 is the point of intersection of S3 and X2, so the 5 is the pivot element. Now, you will write the value of X2. So, how will you write the value of X2? What you will do, you will divide all the value of S3, whatever were the value, you will divide all the value of S3 by the pivot element. So, your pivot element was 5. So, you will divide all the element of S3 by 5 to get the new value of X2. I hope this part is clear. Okay. Now, I believe this part is clear. Now, what I have to do? Now I have to find the value of S1. Now I have to find the value of S1 and S2. Now I have to find the value of S1 and S2. Now, in order to find the value of S1 and S2, what you have to do, because if you see in this problem that 5 was your pivot element. If you see in this problem, the 5 was your pivot element. And the corresponding value of 5 are very significant for you. For S1, 1 is very significant. For S2, 3 is very significant for you. Okay. Now, how will you find the value? How will you find the new value of S1? How will you find the new value of S1? So, what you have to do in order to find the new value of S1, what you have to do, you have to make this variable and this variable 0. For S1 and S2, you have to make both the corresponding value, the whatever was your pivot element, for the now you have to make the corresponding value of that to be 0. So how will you make it zero? So you have to use basic maths for that. So how will you make it zero? For that, you can use your basic maths. You can write the first what you do, make a separate table, make a separate table somewhere here, and I'll write old element. Suppose I want the value of S1. Suppose I want the value of S1. Here I want to write the value of S1. Here I want to write the value of S1. Some value of S1 I want to write. Okay, this two I know would be zero. Now I have to write some value of S1. So how will I write the value of S1? So for that, to in order to write the value of S1, what I'll write first, I'll write the old element of S1. So first I'll write the old element of S1. So what are the old element of S1? First I'll write the value of S1. So for that I have to write the old element of S1. These value write separately somewhere else. Do the some calculation of S1. Write it separately. 1 1 1 0 0. So 1 1 1 0 0. 1 1 1 0 0. This I'm writing old element. 1 1 1 0 0. 1 1 1 0 0. So these 1 1 1 0 0 and the RHS was 10. 1 1 1 0 0 and the RHS was 10. So write it like this. Okay. Then write new element. New element. What are the new? This is old element. This is new element. The new element is the. These are your new element. So the value what you get. These are your new element. These are your new element. Write down this value. Write down this value separately. 1/5, 1 0 0, 1/5. 1/5, 1/5, 1/5, 1, 1/5, 1, 0, 0, 1/5, and 7. So write down this value. So write down this value. So we call them as a new element and this value as a old element. So because I want to find the value of S1, that value of S1 which I can put it here. I want to find the value of S1 which I can put it here. So in order to do that, what I'll do, in order to do that, I'll make a separate table. I'll do separate calculation for that. So I'll do a separate calculation for that. So now the formula what you have to use, for the new value, that would be your old element minus constant into new element. So this formula you have to use. There, what is your constant here? What is your constant? The constant would be the corresponding value of the pivot element. So you want to find S1. So for the S1, what is the corresponding value of S1? For the pivot element, what is the corresponding value? The corresponding value is 1. This for S1, the constant is 1. For S2, the constant is 5. Sorry, the constant is 3. For S1, the constant is 1. For S2, the constant is 3. Okay, so you write it here. Okay, now do this calculation. So 1 minus constant is 1. 1 minus 1 into 1/5. Do this calculation. You'll get 4/5. Then 1 minus. Sorry. Huh, 1 minus. Constant is 1 now. Okay. 1 minus 1 into 1. You'll get 0. Constant is 1. So 1 minus 0 into 1. You'll get 1. Okay. Then 0 minus 0 into 1, you'll get 0. Then 0 minus 1 into 1/5, you get minus 1/5. And then 10 minus 1 into 7, you'll get 3. So these are the new value of S1, which you write it there. See this? Anyone want to ask anything? Please ask me. Anyone want to ask anything, ask me. Okay, so I hope you have seen this. So now this value, you'll put in the question. So 4 by 5, 0, 1, 0, -1 by 5, 3. Put that value here. So you got the value as 4 by 5. You got the value as 4 by 5, 0, 1, 0, 4 by 5, 0, 1, 0, -1 by 5, and then 3. So this is the value of S1. Similarly, you'll find the value of S2. Try the value of S2, everyone. Do the same calculation for S2, what I did for S1. Try everyone. So your new element will always be this only. This would be always be your new element. Just here in here you write the old element of S2. These are your old element of S2. So they are 2, 3, 0, 1, 0. So 2, 3, 0, 1, 0. So do the same calculation for S2. So you can do the same calculation for S2. If you want to do the same calculation for S2, their old element. What are their old element? Their old element are 2, 3, 0, 1, 0. 2, 3, 0, 1, 0. 2, 3, 2, 2, 3, 0, 1, 0. They are the old element. Okay, what is the new element? New element is again the same value, 1 by 5. The x2 value, what you got, 1 by 5, 1, 0, 1 by 5, 1, 0, 0, 1 by 5, 1 by 5, 0, 1 by 5, 1, 0, 0, 1 by 5, and then it was 7. So for S2, what is that value? For S2, the value for that is 25 by 3. For S2, the value was 25. So the value that was 25. So write it here. This is 25. Okay. Now, what is a constant for S2? The constant for S2, you can see the constant is 3. The constant here is 3. Again, apply the same formula. For S2 new element, old element minus 3 into new element, because 3 is a constant. So 2 minus 3 into 1 by 5. So you'll get 7 by 5. Then 3 minus 1 into 3 will get 0. 0 minus this is 0. This is 1 only, because here this is 0. Then 0 minus 3 into 1 by 5. You'll get minus 3 by 5. Then this is 25 minus 7 into 3. You'll get 4. Okay, so simple. The way you did the calculation of S1, the same way you have to do the calculation of S2. Write down this value. See this. Anyone have any doubt? Ask me. Anyone want to ask anything, ask me. Okay, nobody is saying anything. I assuming that you understand it. So 7 by 5, 0, 0, 1, minus 3 by 5 and 4. So write down that value, 7 by 5. So 7 by 5, same thing, 7 by 5, simple. It's very simple, 7 by 5, 0, 0, 1, minus 3 by 5. And 4. So write down that value, 7 by 5, 0, 0, 1, minus 3 by 5 and 4. So 7 by 5, 0, 0, 1, minus 3 by 5 and 4. So write down this value. Okay, so once you're done writing this, then find the ZI. ZI here would be 0 into 4 by 5 plus 0 into 7 by 5. Plus 8 into 1 by 5. This is 8 by 5. Then this is 0 into 0 plus 0 into 0 plus 8 into 1. This is 8. This is 0 into 1 plus 0 into 0 plus 8 into 0. This is 0. Then 0 into 0 plus 8, 0 into 1 plus 8 into 0. This is 0. Then 0 into minus 1 by 5 plus 0 into minus 3 by 5 plus 8 into 1 by 5, this is 8 by 5, and then this is 56. Okay, now find CI minus ZI. So then find CI minus ZI. So you can find CI minus ZI. So first, if you find the CI minus ZI, so this is 6, so 6 minus 8 by 5. What is 6 minus 8 by 5? 6 minus 8 by 5. This is 22 by 5. So you get this as 22 by 5. Okay. So 6 minus 8 by 5. So that is 22 by 5. Okay. Then CI here is 8. 8 minus 8 is 0. 8 minus 8 is 0, then these all are 0. This is minus 8 by 5. This is 8. So 8 minus 8 is 0. So this would be 8 minus 8, 0. This would be 0, 0, minus 8 by 5. Okay, so out of all CI minus ZI, which is the maximum value? The maximum value is 22 by 5. Now, 22 by 5 is correspond to what? 22 by 5 is correspond to X1. It means now X1 will enter into the solution. It means now the X1 will enter into the solution. Now, when X1 is entering into the solution, then X1 will replace either S1 or either S2 or either S3. So for that, you have to determine the theta. So what is the theta of S1? So the theta of S1 is 3 divided by 4 by 5. So you will get 15 by 4. 15 by 4 is 3.75. Then for S2, what is the theta? 4 divided by 7 by 5. 4 divided by 4 divided by 7 by 5. That is 20 by 7. So 20 by 7 is 2.60. 60 means 8. 8 means 40. 2.85. Then the third one, X2, that is 7 divided by 1 by 5. So you will get 35. Okay. So out of all theta, you can see the theta which is minimum. So which theta is minimum? 2.85. It means S2 is leaving the variable. It means S2 is leaving the variable, and S2 is gonna replace by X1. What is 4.4? You are saying I'm not understanding, Kishore. So it means X1 is entering into the solution and x1 is going to replace s2. Now in place of s2, what is the pivot element? So the pivot element for that, this is your pivot element. The pivot element for that is 7/5. So you can write x1 and x2. So s1 is 0, x2 is 8, x1 I believe is 6. Okay, now the same steps you will again repeat. Now you know that the pivot element is 7/5. So first you will find the value of x1. First you will find the value of x1. So how will you find the value of x1? By dividing all the element of s2 by 7/5. 7/5 is the pivot element. Now 7/5 by 7/5 is 1. 0 divided by 7/5 is 0. 0 divided by 7/5 is 0. 1 divided by 7/5 is 5/7. Okay, and then -3/5 divided by 7/5 is -3/7, and 4 divided by 7/5 is 20/7. 7/5 is your pivot element. So 7/5 is your pivot element. So what you will do to write the value of x1, you will divide all the value of s2 by 7/5, because 7/5 is your pivot element. So now divide all the elements of s2 by 7/5, because 7/5 is your pivot element. Yeah, you can write. I prefer fraction because fraction does not confuse us. I don't prefer much decimals. If you're sitting with calculator, you wish. No problem. I prefer fraction because I don't use calculator. That's why I write fraction. Okay, now because you understood the 7/5 is the pivot element of S2. Similarly, the constant for S1 is 4/5, and the constant for X2 is 1/5. So you can, this is the constant of S2. So you have to understand the constant. So what are the constant? So the constant of S1 is 4/5. The constant of X2 is 1/5. So you have to write that. Now, based on that, I'll find the value of S1 and X2. And these value, what you got, these values will call them as the, these values, what you call, will call them as a new element. These values, what I'll got, what I'll call them, I'll call them as the new element. This value, I'll call them as a new element. These are my new element. I'll use them for finding the value of S1 and X2. Where the old value of S1, you can see these are the old value of S1. These all are the old value of S1. Now the same calculation I'll do for them. Okay, now write down the value, old value of S1. This side 4/5, 0. So write down these value. 4/5, 0, 1, 0, -1/5, and 3. So for S1, so I want to do the calculation for S1. S1, the values are for S1, your values are 4/5, 0, 1, 0, -1/5, and then 3. These are the old value of S1. So 4/5, 0, 1, 0, -1/5, and 3. These are the old value of S1. I'm calling them as an old element. Now the new element for you, what are the new element? So the new element value for you is 100 5/7 - 3/7. 100 5/7 - 3/7 and 20/7. These are my new element. And what is my constant? My constant for this is 4/5. So my constant is 4/5. So I'll use the formula that old element minus 4/5 into new element. I'm going to use this formula. My constant, you can see my constant is 4/5. Okay, simple, same kind of calculation you have to do again. So 4/5 - 4/5 is 0. This is 0. This is 1. 1 minus 0. This is minus 4/5 into 5/7. So you'll get minus 4/7. Okay, this is, what is this value? This is -1/5 minus minus plus 4/5 into 3/7. So you'll get 12/35 - 1/5. So if you solve this, you'll take the LCM 35, 12 - 7. So 1/7, 12 - 7. So means 5/35, 5/35 means 1/7. This value is 3 - 4/5 into 20/7. So you'll get 3 - 16/7. 21 - 16 is how much? 5 by 7. You got all these value. So these are the new value of S1. So write down this value. See, anyone have any doubt on this? Very simple. Same kind of calculation. Again, you have to do. It's not at all big thing. You can easily do this thing. Don't raise your hand. Anyone want to ask anything? Ask directly. Okay, so now write down this value. Now this value of S1. So the value of S1, what you got is 0 0 1 - 4/7. 0 0 1 - 4/7. 1/7 and 5/7. So these are the value of S1 you got. So write down this value. Now what I'll do, I'll find the value of X2. Now for the X2, what is your constant? This is your constant for X2. Same way, the way we did for S1, the same way we'll do for S2. So you have to write down the old value of X2, that is 1/5 1 0 0 1/5 7. Write down the old value of X2. Those are your old element. So write down the value of X2. So those are your old element. Write down the values of S2. So those are called old element of S2. What are those values of S2? Not S2, sorry, they are X2. So write down the old element of X2. So what are those values? You can see what are those values. Those values are 1/5, 1/5, 1 0 0, 1/5 and 7. 1/5, 1 0 0, 1/5 and 7. 1/5, 1/5, 1/5, 1 0 0, 1/5 and 7. These are the old value of X2. new element remain constant, the value of x1, what you got, what are the value of x1 you got, these are the value already I have written here, these are the value. So 1 0 0 5 by 7, -3 by 7, 20 by 7, you can write down the same value. So 1 1 0 0 5 by 7, okay, -3 by 7, okay, and then 20 by 7, okay. Now what is the constant for this, what is the constant for that? So what is the constant for this? Constant for this is 1 by 5. Constant for this is 1 by 5. Okay, the constant of this is 1 by 5. So the constant for this is 1 by 5. So you apply the formula, old element minus constant is 1 by 5 into your new element. This is the new value of x2. Same formula, this would be 0. This is 1, this is 0. This is -1 by 5 into 5 by 7. We'll get -1 by 7. This is 1 by 5 minus minus plus 3 by 7 into 1 by 5. So solve this. So if you solve this, you'll get 3 by 35 plus 1 by 5. 35 is the LCM. So 3, this is 10, this is 2 by 7. And this is 7 minus 1 by 5 into 20 by 7. So you get 7 minus 4 by 7. That will give you 45 by 7. Simple. Same calculation we are doing again. Same calculation we are doing again. I hope this is very easy. So same thing, you have to keep doing this thing till that time you will not find ci minus zi equal to 0. So the same calculation you have to do. So now the value of this is 0, 1, 0, minus 1 by 7, 2 by 7 and 45 by 7. Okay. So you can write down these values. 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. So 0, 0, 1, 0, minus 1 by 7, then 2 by 7, and then 45 by 7. So to write down this value, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, minus 1 by 7, then 2 by 7, and then 45 by 7. So you have to do this calculation again and again, and then you find the value of zi. Then you'll find the value of zi. Your zi, what is zi? Zi is 0 into 0 plus 6 into 1 plus 8 into 0. So this would be 6. Then this would be 8. 0 into 0 plus 6 into 0 plus 8 into 1. Then this would be 0 into 1 plus 6 into 0 plus 8 into 0. Okay. Then this would be 30 by 7. And this is 8 by 7. 30 minus 8 means 22 by 7. Okay. And this would be minus 18. And this is 16. So minus 18 means minus 2 by 7. Okay. Okay, so you want this, what is the ZI value for this? This is 120. This is 120. 6 into 20. 120. This is 8 into 45. 45 8 za matlab 94 za. 360. 360 means 480. So 480 by 7. Okay. So once you got this, now you can find CI minus ZI. So you will proceed this calculation till the time CI minus ZI does not become 0 or negative. So this was 6 only. You can see here. This was 6 only. So 6 minus 6 is 0. 6 minus 6 is 0. And this was 8 only. So CI, this is 8 minus 8, 0. Then this was 0 only. This is minus 22 by 7. Minus minus plus. This is 2 by 7. So out of all CI minus ZI, either your ci minus zi should be negative or it should be zero. If any positive value exists, means this is not a feasible solution. So what is the so what is the highest value? The highest value is 2/7. It means 2/7 correspond to what? 2/7 correspond to what? 2/7 correspond to what? 2/7 correspond to S3. It means now S3 will enter into the solution. It means now the S3 will enter into the solution. Now if S3 will enter into the solution, means S3 will replace either S1, either X2, or either X3. How to determine that? For that, I'll determine the theta. So already I know the pivot element. So the pivot element are 1/7. The pivot element are 1/7, minus 3/7, and 2/7. So let's find the theta. So the theta for this would be 5/7 divided by 1/7. This would be 5. The theta of this, so 20/7 minus 3/7 divided by. We never determine the negative value. Never determine the negative value. We never do calculation for negative value. Don't do that. Okay, so the answer for this would be not defined. Now this would be 45/7 by 2/7. So this is 45/2. 45/2 means 22.5. 45/2 means 22.5. So out of the two values you got theta, which is the minimum value? The minimum value is 5. Which one is the minimum value? The minimum value is 5. Means S1 will leave the solution. S1 will leave the solution and S3 will enter into the solution. Okay. And what would be the pivot element? So the pivot element for that, this would be your pivot element. This will be your pivot element. Okay. Now, so now what you'll do now in place of S1, now in place of S1, you'll write S3. S3 with zero coefficient. X1, the coefficient is 6. X2, the coefficient is 8. Now, find the value of S3. Find the value of S3. Find the value of S3. What is the pivot element? What is the value of S3? What is your pivot element? Pivot element is 1/7. So divide everything by 1/7. 0 divided by 1/7, 0, 0, 1 divided by 1/7 means 7, minus 4/7 divided by 1/7, minus 4, 1/7 divided by 1/7, 1, 5/7 divided by 1/7, 5. Do this calculation. Tell me the calculation of X1 and X2, like the do the calculation of X1 and X2 like the same way. So for X1, if you remember again, for X1, if you see minus 3/7 is your constant, and here 2/7 is your constant. So the calculation what we did, this will follow the same calculation, old element minus constant into new element. Now write all the old value of X1. So this would be your new element. Do the same calculation, the calculation what we had done before. Now follow the same calculation. Tell me the value of X1 and X2. Follow the same calculation. Now write down this value of X1. So X1, if I go with X1, 100, 5/7, minus 3/7, 20/7. Do here. So I'm doing X1. So the old element of X1 is 100, 5/7. Then minus 3/7 and then 20/7. These are the old element of X1. What is the new element? the new element for you is S1. So the new element of S1 is what? Sorry, the new element is S3. Sorry, the new element for you is S3. So what are the values of S3 you got? They are 00, 00, 0, 0, 7, minus 4, 1, and 5. These are the new element what you get. Okay, what is the constant you have to use, guys? What is the constant you have to use, guys, for X1? The constant is minus 3 by 7. The constant what you have to use here is minus 3 by 7. The constant you have to use here is minus 3 by 7. So you apply the formula that old element minus 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 plus 3 by 7 into new element. So you apply this formula. So you apply this formula for X1. Do the same calculation. This would be 1. This would be 0. This would be minus. So this is 3. So 3 by 7 into 7. This would be 3. This would be 5 by 7. Okay. So that minus, it will become minus. So minus 3 by 7 into 4. So this would be 12 minus. This would be minus 1. So 12 minus 5. 12 minus 5 is minus 7. Minus 7 by 7. Will get minus 1. Okay. So then this would be minus 3 by 7. And this is plus 3 by 7. So this would be 0 only. Okay. Now this would be 20 by 7 minus 5 plus 5 into 3 by 7. So this would be 5. So 15 plus 20 is 5. So just write down these values. 1, 0, 3, minus 1, 0, and 5. That would be the new element of X1. The new element of X1. So new element of X1. The new element of X1. Write down that value. That value is 1, 0, 3, minus 1, 0, and 5. Okay. Now the same calculation what we did for X1. The same calculation will do for X2 also. But for the X2, your constant would be what? 2 by 7. For X2, your constant would be 2 by 7. Do the same calculation for X2. So write down the values. What are the values? These are your values. What are the values? These are your values of X2. So these are your values of X2. So this is minus 1 by 7. So write down the values of X2. Same way. 0, 1, 0, these are the value of X2. So 0, these are the value of X2. These are your values of X2. So these are your values of X2. So just write down their values. Just write down their values. So X2 old values. So the X2 old values. So for X2 old element, write down the values. What are the values? For X2, what are the values for X2? Is 0, 1, 0, minus 1 by 7, 2 by 7, and 45 by 7. So write down the values. So write down the values. So the value of X2, what you can write is 0, 1, 0, minus 1 by 7, and then 2 by 7. And then 45 by 7. Okay, these are the old element. What are the new element? So your new element, same value for new element. Same value you can repeat for the new element. These are 0, 0, 7, minus 4, 1, and 5. Okay, what is your constant? What is your constant? What is your constant? What is your constant, guys? What is your constant here? Constant is 2 by 7. So constant is here 2 by 7. So the constant what you have to use here is 2 by 7. So you apply the formula old element minus 2 by 7 into new element. Apply that formula. This is 0. This is 0. This is 1. This is minus 2. This is 0. This is 1. This is minus 2. This is minus 1 by 7. Minus minus plus 2 by 7 4. So 8 minus, this is 1. 8 minus 1 is 7. 7 by 7, 1. This would be 0 only. This is 45 by 7 minus 2 by 7 into 5. So you get 35 by 7, matlab 5. Simple. Same thing we are doing again. It's not at all difficult. It's just like kind of monotonous. We are writing the same thing again. Same kind of calculation we are doing again. So 0, 1, minus 2, 1, 0, 5. Write down this value. So write down this value here. So your values are 0, 0, 1, minus 2, 1, 0, and 5. Now based on this, find the ZI. And then find CI minus ZI. Do this calculation, everyone. Do this calculation. Tell me the value of CI minus ZI. Do this calculation. So this would be 0 into 0 plus 6 into 1 plus 8 into 0. So this would be 6. This is 0 into 0 plus 6 into 0 plus 8 into 1. This is 8. 0 into 7 plus 6 into 3, 18. 18 minus 16, this would be 2. Then 0 into minus 4 plus 6 into minus 1, minus 6 plus 8. 8 minus 6, this would be 2. Then this would be 0 only. Okay, and this would be how much? 30 plus 40, 70. Now CI minus ZI. For X1, the CI was 6. 6 minus 6, 0. For X2, the CI was 8. 8 minus 8, 0. This is minus 2. This is minus 2. This is 0. Now, if you notice, all your CI minus ZI is either 0 or negative. Means now you got your feasible solution. So the feasible solution, if you see, the maximum value of Z you got is 70. This is your maximum value of Z, where the value of X1 you got is 5. The value of X1 you got is 5. The value of X2 you got is 5. So that is your final answer. So you have to do this calculation till that time your CI minus ZI either become 0 or they become negative value. Till that time you have to do the calculation. So now I have noticed in this calculation, I've seen my CI minus ZI become 0 or negative, means I'm done with my calculation. Okay, and that give me the value of X1 and X2. Anyone have any doubt? So please forward these videos to other people who are there in other college. You have your friends who are doing MBA from Bangalore City in other college. So if anyone you want, you can give these videos to those people. They can also have a watch on them. I believe this will also help them whenever they are preparing for the exam. We'll cover all the previous year exam papers. One by one, we'll do everything. So this was a very good question. So the idea of doing this question is to make you a more and more practice. Recorded version of this video already you will get very soon, so that you can practice this before the next class. I am not seeing people watching the video. I don't know what is the reason why you people are not serious, why you people are not watching the video in spite of me recording the video for you people, so that you will get benefited. So normally when you attend a class, class get over means work is done. The teacher has taught which may we understand, which may we will not understand, work is done. But this is something else, guys. Here, whatever you are understanding, in case if you miss me while in the class, if in case I'm teaching and you, so because of some reason you missed me, maybe because of internet or maybe because of whatever reason, if you missed me. So you have another one more way to give back to that. So you can go back. It's like a time machine. You can go back to the past and you can see whatever I have done. Because whatever I am doing, I am recording the session. so that you will get benefited from that. So I hope you are understanding the agenda of recording the session, agenda of having this session, and the importance of this subject. This subject is not at all an easy subject, and this is just the journey has just started. So we have to cover a lot of things. We have to cover a lot of topics which are much more difficult than what we are doing right now. So if you do not get serious, if you do not feel motivated, if you do not do enough practice, then the whole level of expectation, what I have from you and the kind of expectation you have from me will not be sustained. Okay, so anyone want to ask anything, please ask me. Anyone want to ask anything, please ask me. So I'm assuming that you have understood whatever I've done till now. So I'm winding up the class. Shruti has already sent me the attendance sheet. I'll use this for the attendance purpose. Okay, guys. Thank you, everyone. I think people can't listen to me because nobody is responding. That's why I wrote through a chat box stating thank you to everyone. Be safe. Okay, take care. God bless you.